Good morning, dear students. First, I wish you a happy new year. In this year, we are starting our lesson. That is 8th chapter. Already we are discussing the 8th chapter, comparing quantities. Is it? Yes. That is, next we are going to discuss about finding discounts. Finding discount. Which way we find the discount? What do you mean by discount? Anyone can say? The discount means, what is the discount means? Discount means when we buy a property or we buy a dress, that is dress price is 100 rupee, we bargain and we get it in 80 rupees. That is, the property or dress price is 100 and next we get it in 80 rupees. That is, there is the difference is 20 rupee. That is, 20 rupee is the discount. And some many shops we also seeing that discount sale is 20% discount sale, 5% discount, is it? Yes. That is, here we discussing about which way we find, which way we find the discount. That is, discount means market price minus selling price. Discount price means market price minus sale price. That is, 100 is the market price, selling price is 75, then discount equal to 100 minus 75. We get 25. Discount is 25. And discount percentage is selling discount divided by market price into 100%. That is, discount percentage is equal to discount by market price into 100%. That is, market price is 100. That is, discount is 25 by 100 and 100%. That is, we get 25% discount. That is, we get 25% discount. That is, for example, that is, an item marked at 840 rupees is sold for 714. What is the discount and discount percentage? What is the discount and discount percentage? That is, first one is, market price discount equal to market price minus selling price. Is it? That is, market price is 840 rupees minus 714. That is, we get, what we get? We get it as 126 is discount. 126 is the discount. That is, discount percentage equal to discount divided by market price into 100%. That is, when we simplifying these, four, two, five, and 21. Here is, we get 6, 3, and next is 2, 1, 7. That is 3. That is 3 into 5. 15%. 3 into 5, 15%. We get as 15%. For another example, For another example, that is the list price of a frock is 220. A discount of 20% announced on sales. What is the announced of discount on and its sale price? Here is discount percentage is given. We want to find the discount amount and its sale price. So first we find the discount percentage. That is, discount percentage is 20%. That means discount amount equal to, what is the discount and amount? That is 20% is discount, that is 20/100 into 220. That is 44 rupees is discounted. That is, we subtract the 44 from 220, we get the selling price. That is, sale price equal to 220 minus 44. That is, we get, what we get? We get 176 rupees. Or we put in the symbol in front. This is rupees, this is also rupees. That is, 220 minus 44, we get 176 rupees. Is it? Or otherwise, in previous class, we also discussed. That is, in other ways, we can say that, what is? We can say that 20% is discount. So, what is the selling price? Selling price equal to, we can find selling price as 220 into 80/100. That is 176. Also we get 176. That is, here we get, I take 80 because 20% is discount. That is, 100 minus 20, we get 80. So, 220 into 80/100, then we get the selling price. We get the selling price. And next is, or try this. Try this is, a shop gives 20% discount. What would be the sale price of each of these? That is, first one is, a dress marked at 120. A dress marked at 120. That is, a part is a dress marked 120. That is, what we make? We make it as what? 120. Into, what is the discount? 20%, is it? Yes. That is 120 into 20/100. That is 24. That is, we get first answer as 120 minus 24, then we get 96. We get 96. That is, first we write that the dress marked at 120 and marked price is of dress is 120 and discount rate is 20%. Discount rate is 20%. That means discount equal to 20% of 120. That is, 20/100 into 120, we get, what we get? We get 24 as discount. That is, the selling price is marked price minus discount, we get 96. $120 minus $24, we get $96. Is it? Yes. Is it? Yes. And next is, Second B part is a pair of shoes marked at 750. Shoe is 750. That is, we want to find first discount. That is 750 into 20%. That is, we get 150. That is, selling price equal to 750 minus 150. That is, we get 600. We get 600. We get 600. Answer, that is, selling price is 600. And next one is a bag marked at 250. A bag marked at 250. That is, discount equal to the marked amount is 250. That is, we take the discount percentage. ₹50 is discount. That is, selling price is equal to marked price minus discount. That is 200. Price is 200. And next question is, a table marked at 50,000 is available for 40,400. Find the discount given and the discount percentage. We want to find the discount and discount percentage. That is, that is, discount equal to discount give what? That is, market price is 50,000 and selling price is 14,400. That is, what we get? We get 600. That is, discount is 600. And discount percentage is 100%. That is 4%. Is it? Is it? That is, which way we get? That is, we get 4%. That is, here also, that is 600. That is, first we cancel the two zeros and from here one and here one, then 60 by 15 we get 4. That is, discount percentage is 4%. Discount percentage is 4%. Is it? Yes. And third one is for your homework. That is, following like this, you get the answer. And next one is estimation in percentage. Estimation in percentage. That is, estimation in percentage means, first round off the bill to the nearest 10. That is, we round off the nearest 10. First one. That is, for example, in a bill show, the amount is 577.80 rupees. Then the shopkeeper gives a discount of 55%. How do we estimate the bill? We want to estimate the percentage. That is, our bill amount is 577.80 577.80 rupees. The shopkeeper gives 50% discount. That is, next what we do. First we do the bill amount is round off. Next, nearest to cash. That is 577.80. 577.80 is nearest to is, that is, when we rounding off, we get the amount is 580. We get 580. Then next we find the 10% of 580, we get 58. Next, secondly, find the 10%. That is, 10% we take, find the amount of discount. That is, here in your textbook, in question, the 15%, but they take as 10%. That is, we take the 10% is 580 into 10/100. That is 58. Next, we take the half of this one. 58. We get 29. We take the half of 58. That is 29. Next, add the amount first and second. That is, first is 58 and second one is 29. Then we get what? 87. We get 87. That is, we get what is the discount rate? That is 87 or 85. That is approximately 495. That is, our bill amount is 577.80. We convert or round off to 580. Next, we find 10% of bill amount, or otherwise we can find 580 into 15/100. That is 58 into 15. We get, that is 87 rupees discount. That is 580 minus 87. That is, we save the bill amount approximately 495. Okay. And next is, we are to estimate 20% of same bill amount. 20% of same bill amount. That is, first we round off this one, that is 580. That is, next we find 20% of 580. That is 160 rupees. That is 580 minus 160, we get 464. That is approximately 465. And next is we get what is next is find the 50% of 375. Find the 50% of 375. We want to find the 50% of 375. That is, here we can find 375 into 50, that is 2, 7, 3, 18, 5, 7, 3, 5, 12, 16, and 4 and 5. That is, here we get 5625 by 100, we get 56.25. Otherwise, here we round off 380. That is, we round off 375 as 380. That is, that is 38 into 50. That is 44, 98, 3. That is 0, 70. That is, here we get 57. That is 375. That is, find the, when finding the percentage of 50% of 375, we get as 57 approximately, or 55 approximately. Okay, yes. And next is price related to buying and selling profit and loss. That is, when we for a school fair or mela, I am going to put a stall of lucky clips. I will charge 10 rupees for one lucky clip, but I will buy items which are worth 5. That is, in a school mela, I start a clip stall. That is, clip stalls, in clip stalls, one clip's price is 10 rupees. The actual amount is 5. Then, so you are making a profit of 100%. Is it? That is, 5 is the actual price. But I sell in 10 rupees. So we can say that is in 100%. And next is, now I will spend 3 on paper to work the gift and tape. So my expenditure is 8 rupees. This gives me a profit of 2, which is 2 by 8 into 100, we get 25% only. That is 100% is my profit. Next, I spend 3 rupees on paper and for a gift, work paper and tape, and total expenditure is 5 plus 3 is 8. So we get, what is the profit? Actual rate is then 8 rupees, selling rate is 10 rupees, that is, actual profit is 2. That is, 2 by 8 into 100, we get 25%. Is it? Yes. That is, sometimes when a article is bought, some additional expense are made while buying or before selling. The expense have to be included in the cost price. That is, we are familiar with the online shopping, is it? Yes. Sometimes they make or they take the transporting charges, is it? Yes. Sometimes they didn't take the transporting charge. That is, the expense are sometimes referred to the as overhead charges. The expense is normally we can say that what is overhead charges. This may include an expense like amount spent on fares, labor charge, transportation, etc. That is, these are the overhead charges. You just read your textbook page number 122. Okay, today I conclude my class. Be safe, stay safe. Bye.